Next we'll be next instalment for certain features of the historical development of Marxism. And we're up to Karl Marx. Karl Marx was born May 5th, 1818 in the city of Trier, Rhenish Prussia. His father was a lawyer, a Jew who in 1824 adopted Protestantism. The family was well-to-do, cultured but not revolutionary. After graduating from a gymnasium in Trier, Marx entered the university first at Bonn and later at Berlin, where he read law, majoring in history and philosophy. He concluded his university course in 1841, submitting a doctoral thesis on the philosophy of Epicurus. At the time, Marx was a Hegelian idealist in his views. In Berlin, he belonged to a circle of left Hegelians, Bruno Bauer and others, who sought to draw aesthetic and revolutionary conclusions from Hegel's philosophy. After graduating, Marx moved to Bonn, hoping to become a professor. However, the reactionary policy of the government, which deprived Ludwig Feuerbach of his chair in 1832, refused to allow him to return to the university in 1836, and in 1841 forbade young professor Bruno Bauer to lecture at Bonn, made Marx abandon the idea of an academic career. Left Hegelian views were making rapid headway in Germany at the time. Ludwig Feuerbach began to criticize theology, particularly after 1836, and turned to materialism, which in 1841 gained the ascendancy in his philosophy, The Essence of Christianity. The year 1843 saw the appearance of his Principles of the Philosophy of the Future. One must have oneself have experienced the liberating effect of these books. Engels subsequently wrote of these works of Feuerbach. We, i.e. the left Hegelians, including Marx, all became at once Feuerbachians. At that time, some radical boys in the Rhineland who were in touch with the left Hegelians founded in Cologne an opposition paper called Rheinische Zeitung. The first issue appeared on January 1st, 1842. Marx and Bruno Bauer were invited to be the chief contributors, and in October 1842 Marx became editor-in-chief and moved from Bonn to Cologne. The newspaper's revolutionary democratic trend became more and more pronounced under Marx's editorship, and the government first imposed double and triple censorship on the paper, and then on January 1st, 1843 decided to suppress it. Marx had to resign the editorship before that date, but his resignation did not save the paper, which suspended publication in March 1843. Of the major articles Marx contributed to Rheinische Zeitung, Engels notes, in addition to an article on the condition of peasant vine groves in Moselle Valley. Marx's journalistic activities convinced him that he was insufficiently acquainted with political economy, and he zealously set out to study it. In 1843, Marx married at Krasnach Jenny von Westphalen, a childhood friend he'd become engaged to while still a student. His wife came of a reactionary family with Prussian nobility, her elder brother being Prussia's Minister of the Interior during the most reactionary period, 1850-1858. In the autumn of 1843, Marx went to Paris in order to publish a radical journal abroad, together with Arnold Rouge, 1802-1880, left Hegelian, in prison 1825-30, a political exile following 1848 and a Bismarckian after 1886-70. Only one issue of this journal, Durchschau's Rheinische Bücher, appeared. Publication was discontinued owing to the difficulty of secretly distributing it in Germany and to disagreement with Rouge. Marx's articles in this journal showed that he was already a revolutionary who advocated merciless criticism of everything existing, and in particular criticism by weapon, and appealed to the masses and to the proletariat. In September 1844, Friedrich Engels came to Paris for a few days, and from that time on became Marx's closest friend. They both took a most active part in the then-seething life of the revolutionary groups in Paris. of particular importance at the time was Proudhon's philosophy, 1847, waging a vigorous struggle against the various doctrines of Petit Bourgeois socialism. They worked out the theory and tactics of revolutionary proletarian socialism or communism. At the insistent request of the Prussian government, Marx was banished from Paris in 1845 as a dangerous revolutionary. He went to Brussels. In the spring of 1847, Marx and Engels joined a secret propaganda society called the Communist League. They took a prominent part in the League's Second Congress, London, November 1847, at whose request they drew up the celebrated Communist Manifesto, which appeared in February 1848. With the clarity and brilliance of genius, this work outlines a new world conception. Consistent materialism, which also embraces the realm of social life dialectics as the most comprehensive and profound doctrine of development. The theory of the class struggle and of the world historic revolutionary role of the proletariat, the creator of a new communist society. On the outbreak of the Revolution of February 1848, Marx was banished from Belgium. He returned to Paris, whence, after the March Revolution, he went to Cologne, Germany, where New Orange Zeitung was published from June 1st, 1848 to May 1849, with Marx as editor-in-chief. The new theory was splendidly confirmed by the course of the revolutionary events of 1848-49, just as it has been subsequently confirmed by all proletarian and democratic movements in all countries of the world. The victorious counter-revolutionaries first instigated court proceedings against Marx. He was acquitted on February 9th, 1849, and then banished him from Germany May 16th, 1849. First, Marx went to Paris, was again banished after the demonstration of June 13, 1849, and then went to London, where he lived till his death. His life as a political exile was a very hard one, as the correspondence between Marx and Engels, published in 1913, clearly reveals. Poverty weighed heavily on Marx and his family. Had it not been for Engels' constant and selfless financial aid, Marx would not only have been unable to complete Capital, but would have inevitably been crushed by want. Moreover, the prevailing doctrines and trends of Petit Bourgeois socialism and of non-proletarian socialism in general forced Marx to wage a continuous and merciless struggle and sometimes to repel the most savage and monstrous personal attacks. Marx, who stood aloof from circles of political exiles, developed his materialist theory in a number of historical works, devoting himself mainly to a study of political economy. Marx revolutionized this science in his contribution to the Critique of Political Economy, 1859, and Capital, Volume 1, 1867. The revival of the democratic movements in the late 50s and in the 60s recalled Marx to practical activity. In 1864, September 28, the International Working Men's Association, the celebrated First International, was founded in London. Marx was the heart and soul of this organization and author of its first address and of a host of resolutions and declarations and manifestos in uniting the labor movement of various countries, striving to channel into joint activity the various forms of non-proletarian free Marxist socialism. Mazzini, Proudhon, Bakunin, liberal trade unionism in Britain, Lasalleian vacillations to the right in Germany, etc., and in combating the theories of all these sects and schools, Marx hammered out a uniform tactics for the proletarian struggle of the working class in the various countries. Following the downfall of the Paris Commune, 1871, to effective and revolutionary analysis, the Civil War in France, 1871, and the cleavage caused by the Bakunists and the International, the latter organization could no longer exist in Europe. After the Hague Congress of the International, 1872, Marx had the General Council of the International transferred to New York. The First International had played its historical part and now made way for a period of a far greater development of the labor movement in all countries in the world, a period in which the movement grew in scope and mass, socialist working class parties and individual national states were formed. Marx's health was undermined by his strenuous work in the International and his still more strenuous theoretical occupations. He continued work on the refreshing of political economy and on the completion of Capital, for which he collected a mass of new material and studied a number of languages, Russian for instance. However, ill health prevented him from completing Capital. His wife died December 2, 1881, and on March 14, 1883, Marx passed away peacefully in his armchair. He lies buried next to his wife at Highgate Cemetery in London. Of Marx's children, some died in childhood in London when the family were living in destitute circumstances. Three daughters married English-French socialists, Eleanor Aveling, Laura Lafargue, and Jenny Longuet. The latter son is a member of the French Socialist Party. And that ends that installment of certain features of the historical development of Marxism.